Namaste friends, welcome back to our channel. Today I would like to share the Ayurvedic seasonal regimen for Vasanta Rutu or Vasanta Rutucharya. Rutucharya is the ancient Ayurvedic practice and is comprised of two words. Rutu means season and charya means to follow a routine or regimen. Rutucharya consists of lifestyle and Ayurvedic diet routine to cope with the bodily and mental impacts caused by seasonal changes. Rutucharya is a powerful health-giving Ayurvedic tool that helps us to live according to the changes in the season and make internal adjustments so that our doshas are in a state of balance. Vasanta Rutu or Spring or Early Summer. Chaitra and Vaishakha months of Indian calendar or mid-March to mid-May constitute Vasanta Rutu. This year it started from 13th April, that is Hindu New Year Yugadi. It is Adana Kala or Uttarayana. Here sun and wind are extremely powerful. Sun takes off all the energy and strength from people and the cooling qualities from earth. This season is considered as season of flowers and origin of new leaves. Dominant rasa during this Vasanta Rutu is Kashaya or astringent and dominant Mahabhuta or Prithvi and Vayu. In every season, due to changes in climate and changes in the Pancha Mahabhuta or basic elements, there is a corresponding change in the doshas in our body. So, we are asked to eat, drink, exercise, bath, sleep and do all our daily routines with slight modifications in every Rutu. Just before spring, there are two winter seasons, early winter and late winter. In these seasons, cold in the atmosphere starts drawing Agni inwards in the body. The intensity of the sun is much less. So, Agni begins to concentrating in the costa or gastrointestinal tract. Hence, we have a strong appetite and feel intensely hungry in winter. To provide warmth to the body and to pacify the heightened Agni, we are asked to eat rich, heavy, oily and slightly difficult to digest foods. After this 4 months of winter, sudden change to spring or Vasanta, the climate starts to become warm and sun's intensity increases. In winter, there will be accumulation of kapha in our body and is called as Sanchaya. This high accumulated kapha melts and starts running in the body as mucus throughout the body in Vasanta. It is called as Prakopa. So, we start getting spring fever, hay fever, skin allergies, cold, cough, sinusitis, etc. This liquefied kapha dosha, if aggravated, can weaken digestive fire or Agni. When Agni is weak, our appetite is poor. This may lead to lack of interest in food, tiredness and fatigue. So, it is our aim to protect Agni. We need to work on this liquefied kapha. Let us see the diet and lifestyle during Vasanta Rutu. First thing is food. Avoid heavy, oily, sweet and sour foods in this season. Curd and milk sweets are contraindicated in Vasanta Rutu. One can use buttermilk. Light and easily digestible foods like ash gourd, bottle gourd, snake gourd, radish, etc. and foods tasting bitter, pungent and astringent like bitter gourd, fenugreek or neem can be used in Vasanta Rutu. Chewing 5 new leaves every day improves your immunity level. It is a tradition in Karnataka to eat Bevu Bella or mixture of neem and jaggery on Yugadi or New Year. While using grains, use whole grains. If you don't have whole grains, slightly roast the grain and use. Millets are best for Vasanta Rutu. They are light and drying, so their addition can help to absorb and dry out liquefied kapha. Similarly, yava or barley is also considered as a good grain during Vasanta Rutu. Regarding pulses, mudga or green gram is best for Vasanta Rutu. Honey has kapha pacifying properties, so one can use honey in Vasanta Rutu. In Vasanta, we have to use Usna or hot spices which has Agni kindling Deepaka and digestive Pachaka and kapha drying properties like turmeric, dry ginger, clove, cardamom, pepper, etc. Turmeric is astringent and drying, which helps to absorb excess liquids in the body. Dried ginger is warming and without aggravating pitta. Similarly, clove and cardamom both warming without aggravating pitta. Pepper is recommended to balance excess kapha, aids in digestion and opens up strothosis. Pana or drinks for Vasanta Rutu. In Vasanta, instead of raw or unboiled water, Ayurveda advises water must be boiled. Boiling process is to reduce the wateriness and improve the digestibility of water. We can also drink water which has been boiled mildly with dried ginger powder or with musta or cypress rotundus. We have to get up early in the morning and do moderate vyayama or physical exercise to increase heat and provoke sweating in the body to encourage drying and removal of excess kapha dosha. Nadi Shodhana, Kapalabhati and Bhastrika Pranayama are suggested to improve lung health in Vasanta Rutu. Along with this, we can also practice Jalaniti. These techniques helps to dry kapha and improves warmth in the body. Day sleeping is strictly prohibited in Vasanta Rutu to prevent the accumulation of kapha dosha. In Vasanta Rutu, we have to take bath with the Sukoshna Jala or warm water and not with the cold water. And dry massage should be done regularly. Vamana and Nasya are the two Shodhana or Panchakarma therapies can be done in Vasanta Rutu. They can help to move large amount of liquid kapha from the body. These therapies are recommended in chronic sinusitis, high tendency to catch cold or kapha dominant prakritis where kapha is severely aggravated. Friends, these are the do's and don'ts during Vasanta Rutu. Ayurvedic health guidelines are extremely powerful and potent. The importance of following Rutucharya is that we are able to stop disease even before it starts. It also balances all tridoshas in our body and keeps us fit and healthy throughout the year. During this pandemic, please follow these rules and stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you for watching.